Now let's talk about best practices when using 2D images and animations in AR. As I mentioned before, optimization is really key. Unless you need transparency or are using flat-colored graphic images, I recommend using JPEGs. They can be compressed to much smaller sizes, and every byte counts when you're creating AR. Due to the way computers and graphics cards process data, it's often a good idea to use power of two images. A power of two image is one that has an aspect ratio of 1:1 or 2:1, where the sides are either a multiple of 2 or 8. These are some common power of two image dimensions. Although this is becoming less of an issue with modern technologies, it's still a good optimization technique at the moment. As a 2D animator, I've had to figure out the smartest ways to use 2D animations in AR because they can be quite large. This is because they need to be imported as PNG sequences, which means every single frame is an individual PNG file. They get very large very quickly, and to avoid this, I try to keep my file dimensions as small as possible, and I also try to keep my frame rate as low as possible while maintaining fidelity. Personally, I try to keep my animations between 12 to 20 frames per second. Here's a tip. If you use Photoshop files that contain layers in Aero, it will automatically create an illustration with depth. Simply drag and drop the PSD file right onto Aero's 3D workspace, then adjust the layer spacing in the Properties panel. There we have it. Easy peasy.